All but one of the patients that were taken from the scenes last night were brought to Central Maine Medical Center. One was transported directly to St. Mary's Medical Center here in Lewiston. Of those patients, two were treated and discharged. One of those patients was transferred from Central Maine Medical Center to Maine Medical Center in Portland. Three patients, unfortunately, passed away in Central Maine Medical Center last night. Of those, eight remain now, and we have five patients who are in stable condition, three who are in critical condition in our critical care unit. Just to give you a sense of the scope of what we dealt with within a relatively short period of time, last night, within about 45 minutes to an hour, we had six fully staffed and running operating rooms at Central Maine Medical Center caring for the wounded and the victims. The professionals that were operating simultaneously in those six operating rooms included orthopedic surgeons, general trauma surgeons, urologists, vascular surgeons, as well as anesthesiologists and support personnel.
This heinous attack, which has robbed the lives of at least 18 Mainers and injured so many more, is the worst mass shooting that the state of Maine has ever experienced and could ever imagine. Right before I came into this building, I had a call from the deputy director of the FBI, who told me that there are 80 FBI agents on site participating in the search for the killer. 80. That doesn't include other people from the Marshal's Office, from the ATF, the DEA, and the Department of Homeland Security, and the Coast Guard.
Sometimes things happen that bring your worst nightmares to life. Yesterday, this is what happened in Lewiston. At a time like this, a leader is forced to grapple with things that are far greater than his or herself. Humility is called for as accountability is sought by the victims of a tragedy such as this one. Out of fear of this dangerous world that we live in and my determination to protect my own daughter and wife in our home and in our community, because of a false confidence that our community was above this and that we could be in full control, among many other misjudgments, I have opposed efforts to ban deadly weapons of war like the assault rifle used to carry out this crime. The time has now come for me to take responsibility for this failure, which is why I now call on the United States Congress to ban assault rifles like the one used by the sick perpetrator of this mass killing in my hometown of Lewiston, Maine. For the good of my community, I will work with any colleague to get this done in the time that I have left in Congress.
I think it is more important that we ban very high capacity magazines. I think that would have more input and more effectiveness. We had an assault weapon ban, which I supported, that was in effect for 10 years. It applied to, I believe, 17 or 19 styles of weapons. Later, the late Senator Dianne Feinstein proposed an expansion that would have covered 157 weapons, and it was based not on functionality, but on cosmetic features. So there's always more that we can do.